Cultists love their symbols, don't they? Anybody else heard that before? Occultists love their symbols. A couple guys happen to be hardcore occultists. Yeah, ladder climbers at the local Masonic temple or coven network. Then that might explain why they like to have like a YouTube channel set up like the image of an eyeball or an open book trying to feed you a false gospel.
You're a victim. You're a victim. You're a victim. You're a victim of felony crimes. You're a victim of felony crimes. You're a victim of felony crimes. Just remember, you're a victim of felony crimes. Okay? You've been through hell, and somebody needs to stand for you, and I will do that. You're a victim.
One thing that it's important to remain aware of is the great power of the tongue. We need to always be careful of what is coming out of our own mouth, as well as to stay cautious of what we allow to be spoken over us. Manipulation is an act that's lumped in with witchcraft. Let's just take a quick look at any other. Let's just take a quick look at some clips that may or may not also suggest some sort of witchcraft related, occult related foundation. On this tongue that's speaking to us, trying to speak to us.
I will have an internet radio program that's going to be coming out every single night of the week at 7 o'clock, at 7:07 and 77 seconds. That radio program will play every single night of the week. Okay? It'll be a wonderful thing. If you want to learn more about the biography of Jesus Christ, I would recommend you start with the Gospel of John and work your way backwards. Start on John and work your way backwards to Matthew. So instead of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John in the order of the way that the New Testament Bible is laid out, you'd go the opposite. You'd go John, Luke, Mark, and Matthew. And start at John first and see how that speaks to your heart and your life. It's a beautiful thing. Backwards, backwards, backwards.
What is Kabbalah? What is Jewish mysticism?
Listen to you, I want to love you up. Even though right now things seem very tragic and difficult, and you're probably isolated and depressed and going through different issues, I want you to know that I love you and God loves you. I really am spiritually fighting the fight of my life for you. I care about you. I love you. And there's nothing I won't do to try and help comfort you and ease the pain and burden of what's occurring against you any way I can. This needs to end. It's impossible to stop gang stalking, just so you know. I'm on your side, and I love Jesus Christ, so I have a very big God. Trust in Him. So I love you guys. If you need somebody to talk to, if you need somebody to reach out to, you can go to Salvation Armies and visit with different Salvation Army soldiers like me. There's no people in Salvation Army soldiers. Money's not something that anyone is interested in.
Salvation Army, Red Shield, Rothschild, Hidden Hand, Google it.
We're here to serve. We're saved to serve. We're here for you. We want to reach out to you and love you up and do the best we can to just share the gospel with you, but most importantly, share love with you and just love you up regardless if you're a Christian or even interested in that or not. It is no concern to us. I'm here to serve you. I love you. Share these to your Facebook groups. It's very important. And every one of those videos needs to be copied, needs to be shared. Share them in your Facebook groups or with other people. Copy them on your computer. That's important. So anyways, guys, I love you. Take care, and I'll talk soon.
We're working hard for you guys. We really are. There's some people, and I'm doing this 24/7. Like I said, it's not uncommon that at least every other day I'm getting calls.
from 2 a.m. to 5 a.m., keep calling. You know, if you need help and you need me and you just need somebody to know that, that somebody's there for you, I am. I love you guys. I mean that. I am.
I am.
I have had experience with the cultists. I have had experience with witchcraft being done against me and on and around me, and what a mess. I have had experience with Freemasons. My life, my well-being, my physical body being threatened. So God's given me an eye for this sort of, to watch after this sort of thing, I think. Yeah, and so back to the power of the tongue. When this man, Andrew Boswell, when a video was made questioning him by a Christian man, Andrew's response was to call the guy an idiot 5 times, right? He didn't address any of the points that were made, and he didn't talk about who made the video. And I believe that's because he did not want people to go and to look up on YouTube Gang Stalking and the Occult by the War on the Saints channel. It exposes a thing or two about this guy that we ought to think about before just consuming his content. We really ought to. And at any rate, he made a video after questions were asked about him in a non-accusatory manner. Some questions were brought up by someone who, like me, just cares for people. You know, if I suppose if you notice something, you know, that other people haven't caught on to yet, that's not some advantage you have over them. That's a opportunity for you to share that with someone who's been busy with other things. You know, I was freed up to notice all this. I was glad to see that broadcast, and I'm now glad to to make my own, whatever this turns into. Hope you like it. Like I said, hope you like the little Prince jokes I threw in there and stuff like that. I'm trying to have fun with it, with the heavy, unpleasant subject matter. It's all for love. It's all for love. I love you. I love you. I even love this poor lost wolf. I do. And it's, some people are hard to love, you know, but it's, he is under some serious control, and he is very controlling individual. You'll see actually on his Facebook profile, control is some, he's into control. He admittedly enjoys control, you know, which is manipulation, intimidation, and domination are the three facets of witchcraft, again. And so I'm bringing up that control, aka domination, and I'm bringing up intimidation and manipulation because here's what else. When he made a broadcast after having attention drawn to him, his response was to call the guy an idiot 5 times. Five or so times. I didn't count specifically. Don't let me lie. I'll try not to let me lie. He calls the guy an idiot 5 times. And then he delves into a story. And I'm just gonna, I've clipped it. I've chopped up some highlights for y'all. And again, I am not lying. I did not repeat any of this. This is not a copy and paste joke. Okay, this is just cutting out the in-between words so that you can notice what words were said over and over and over and over to your ears. Why, Mr. Boswell? I know why. I know why, because like I said, I have had many dealings with occultists and with people who have threatened my life and my well-being. I've been threatened with rape. I've been threatened with rape multiple times. Guess what? Praise the Lord, it never happened. Okay? Turn to God, guys. He loves you. He can keep you safe. He can keep you safe from men who are 2 and 3 times your size. In Jesus' name, and he will. Okay. Living testimony right here. This, we're talking more than one individual directly stated to my face. Okay. So I learned that this, that rape is this trigger word. Okay. That these dominators or even witchcraft practitioners, specifically, and perhaps that's one reason why it became so clear to me that this guy is some sort of warlock, like that he's not just a dominator in the physical, like he is in dark rooms channeling spirits intentionally into his being, and that is just what I see, right? I can't go to court with that. I don't have paper documented evidence in that, but I am serious. That is what I see when I look at this man, and I feel sorry for what's coming for him. They love to trigger you with the word rape. They love to trigger fear. It makes you vulnerable. It makes you vulnerable. And let's see if any of it's possible that somebody might be trying to trigger you with any fear. Let's just take an objective look at this clip that I clipped together. Hope you're having a good day.
So what I'm going to do too is just first give you an idea. Okay, so when my targeting first started, the reason is there was a man named Jeremy Gunderson. He was raping a bunch of women in the community and forcing them to be informants for them, making them call him pet names and then having him ask them to send like vagina shots and different inappropriate pictures to him, and then ultimately also forcing them into having sex. So the sexual battery and the felony crimes against him, the problem we run into is they were dropped because two different police departments chose to pay off the victim if she would drop the charges. And see, what I did is I went to the FBI. I first went to the city police and realized that they would not do anything about it. And I was even told that some people could get hurt in making accusations like that. So I knew then that probably somebody would try and hurt me, or my life could be in danger. So I almost had like a nervous breakdown. This was horrible when they started illegally targeting me. And when they put me on a watch list too, they felony raped. These guys were using like anesthetic gas and going into people's houses while they're sleeping. People would break into my house all the time. That's real common for the gang stalking. But it sounded like they were using anesthetic gas or some other type of drugs, and there was lots of rape and abuse occurring. So, you know, I can't prove any of that, but the feds did prove that he was raping this girl and stuff. So, thank goodness she got a little bit of money out of it. She deserved a lot more. Gunderson made sexual advances, forced her to have sex with him, hide this felony crime of rape, felony raped, rape. So that's what they do. Murdered someone, allowed this felony rape to occur, and he was not held accountable for the felony rapes and stuff. I was worried, you know, when you have a rapist police officer out in the community raping women and stuff, and then hearing that he was involved in home invasions of women while they rape them and stuff, or rapes cops that are felony rapists, and the Christian persecution, did sexual battery, felony rape, sexually explicit things, raped her, Christian persecution. They hate me for being a Christian because he's a Freemason Satanist also. A felony rape, and for the officer to not be held accountable for those felony rapes and things. But this one now is a different one. So he killed somebody, Eric Brandon Thompson. He was an Olmsted County Sheriff's deputy, and the person that was killed was Ronald Carlson, killing the husband, Ronald Carlson, and severely wounding Terry Carlson, the wife who had to, you know, see her husband killed. I killed somebody. Kills these people. This murder, this killing, runs these people over. He killed the people he killed. Imagine what she thought for killing these people. But they put him in a job as a fireman, and you know, with a higher paying job. He slams into two pedestrians, which are Terry Carlson and Ronald Carlson, who he killed. They were walking on the side of the road. He runs into them, kills the husband, blood in the body part. The victim, two victims are hurt, but the one dies. The Ronald Carlson did die. This felony murder, killing, running over of these people, covered it all up, you know, after this killing. Poor victim and the victim's family, the person that he killed. Christian persecution, you know, I get phone calls at 4 a.m. constantly and things like that. So TI's out there, I love it, each and every one of you, and I'm praying for you, and I'm putting together a worldwide ministry. I'm talking to people all over the world already. We're not perfect at all. I never said I was. I've been in the deliverance ministry for a short period of time, but I can sure tell you I have a sincere heart, and I'm doing what I'm supposed to, and there's an anointing on my life too, so that's why I'm able to get the support and help that I need. So with Christian persecution, felony burglary, go in my house and rip up my suits. So, not only suits, you know, this is a couple $100, you know, things like that. I don't have the money for that. People come in, and the reason I'm mentioning this too is a lot of people on Facebook, with the targeting, when these people enter your house and do this, a lot of times they take your clothes. So if you get some new pairs of jeans, they'll cut the stitching or they'll put little slits on them. So after you wash them like 2-3 times, all of a sudden they develop holes all over and your jeans are useless. The socks, to be funny, they'll put little holes in all these. And these are brand new and old ones, your t-shirts. They'll rip, and they'll do it in ways that it's not just like obviously ripping it out, but there'll be little parts with razors and stuff, so they'll have holes and things. Christian persecution. I'm out here trying to do my best just to help anybody any time I can. People contact me 24/7. They have full access to my life. I get idiots on YouTube that actually are dumb enough to go out and make a video about me trying to slander me and things. So I'm getting gang stalked by people that are claiming to be Christians, putting together channels and saying that this isn't even human people doing it. It's spiritual warfare, and they stopped their gang stalking. It's impossible to stop gang stalking, just so you know.
My mom always taught me that if you leave your zippers unzipped when you put something in the wash, like the zipper of a hoodie or a pair of jeans or something, that it snags on your clothes, and that's what makes the tiny little holes. Sometimes we forget to zip up the jeans and button them before we throw them in the wash. Or, you know, go with Andrew. Go with what this guy's telling you, that somebody's, and just be afraid, you know, just be worried all the time that people are coming into your house just to make tiny little holes in your clothes. Maybe you forgot to zip and button your jeans, I'm just saying. Like, he's trying to put fear into people from what I can see, you know. I mean, do you feel better? Do you feel better after watching this? Do you feel better? Do you feel calm and peace and the love of Christ? Or do you perhaps feel a little triggered? Do you feel on edge? Have you just been told, and not to be a broken record about witchcraft and divining and manipulation, but the man's going to say things like, imagine, right? He wants you to imagine being raped. He said, imagine how that woman feels. Her husband was murdered. Like, that's really negative smut for your mind. That's not ministry of Christ. It's just not. That's fear tactics, fear mongering. That's triggering your fears and your worries and concerns. And that's trying to center your mind on worrying about who's going to hunt you down and murder you because there's like little snag holes in your clothes. It's just not good. I don't like it.
April 20th, 2014, I signed the Soldier's Covenant. I became a Salvation Army soldier.
Just a worthless liar. I am just an imbecile. I will only complicate you. Trust in me and fall as well. I will find a center in you. I will chew it up and leave. Trust me, trust me, trust me, trust me, trust me.
In fact, do you notice what I notice? How he's using these fear tactic words, and then he's lumping them in over and over with this Christian persecution. And he keeps, like, he keeps putting it into our heads that the relation between these horrible, scary things happen is to the Christian identity and what I get from that is he, like, again, you have to look past, like, the surface. We have to look past the surface of what someone is saying, you know, to judge their actions, their spirits, and the fruit of what they're doing. So I believe when we look past the surface, if all this rough language and seeming to be angry about Christian persecution, I think functionally what happens in these scenes like this, in a lot of his videos actually, although some of them appear to be all right, you know, a little love and love, it's a whole loaf, a little rat poison will kill you. You know, like, you could be a whole lot of water in that bottle, and all you need is a minute amount of poison, and that'll do it. So, while he seems to be, like, talking about Christian persecution, like, it's a bad thing, and that's what makes him angry, like functionally, doesn't it seem like he wants people to be afraid to be Christian? Like, what if there was an intention behind the surface, okay, that, I guess, in this world, some people operate in this way, right? They have intentions other than what they present up front. They've got their own motivations. They've got their own selfish ambitions or loyalties to whatever cause they may be loyal to. And so, doesn't it seem like that he is almost... doesn't it seem like he's almost between the lines, under the surface, advising people to turn away from Christ? Like, he's talking about, here's all these terrifying things that can happen, and he's throwing out just dozens of trigger words. Like, all at once, like, within minutes, it's, like, overwhelming. Like, I can't, like, I'm not, I'll just say it's, a frustrating process just to watch these clips, honestly. Like, I put this off for a minute, like, and I went to go work on the J-Brad video, because that's not pleasant either, but it's not this. This is something. So what if the tactic, the reasoning behind this presentation and these words that he's saying was actually to lay a seed in people's minds about, well, boy, a lot of this bad stuff would stop happening if I just stopped being a Christian, right? If I just stop turning from Christ, that they're persecuting me for being a Christian. And he says they're persecuting him for being a Christian, because he keeps on saying that, and he keeps telling me that they're persecuting me for being a Christian, if they want to follow me and track my phone and cut holes in my clothes after in the laundry while they're in the laundry, like, and rape and murder family members and these type of things that he's putting into our mind, that the reason they're doing this is because you're Christian. Now, at some level, we know that as Christians there's persecution and there's truth to that, but but the truth that I find from reading the word, or even listening to a spirit-filled pastor talk about persecution, is not the flavor of these words. And this is like an attack on the senses, I feel like, when I watch this guy's videos. Like, and I'm at least, maybe because I'm farther away from the worst of it, you know, so my perspective is like that. Like, I don't need fear to be fed. I don't need anger to be fed, you know. Like, I forgive these people who have hurt me and threatened me. Like, I feel sorry for them. Like, I feel sorry for Andrew Boswell, because I see this really dark, nasty manipulation tactic He wants to put the fear of the devil in you and for you to fear man, what man can do to you and what government agencies and neighborhood watch can do to you, that you ought to just go ahead and turn away from Christ so that things get a little easier. Like, is it just me? Do you notice that too? Like, I notice that, and it's enough to lead me to, like, watch all these videos, put all this time learning how to make a video just so I can point that out. And I hope you've already, you know, noticed that somewhere inside you that something's not right about this guy. Am I right? Then go with that. Don't push that aside just because he tells you to, just because he tells you that anybody that speaks against him is an idiot. Don't listen to a wolf like that, please.
Thing. When I noticed that the felony persecution was occurring against me with the hate crimes against me for being a Christian, I noticed that the stalking and things, when they would increase and cut notches into my steering wheel, I have to file police reports on that, or they kill animals and I have to file police reports on that. So when these things were occurring, I noticed that, yeah, I was being stalked around, and then, you know, when my friend tipped me off and told me that the sheriff's department, different law enforcement agencies coordinate that type of thing, and there's programs out there that are intended to be good, but are being perverted and misused if they're used as a revenge tactic, as they are against me. And then also, too, the one thing that not many people talk about is the ability to speak out of the phone, also the technology. So if you're laying in bed, if somebody wanted to be a cruel individual, they could actually, you know, play a program on there, like a funny song, and you're not even aware of it, you're not awake. And that's the type of tools that they have readily available. So if somebody wants to sit this and you lay by your head when you go to bed, you're thinking of this as some type of safety net, so if you have to, you can call. But the problem is, the people that sometimes you may call might have dark hearts themselves and not really care too much about your well-being, and that's a possibility and something that you have to take into consideration. So with that being said, if this is on your bed and I'm out there and I want to speak in your phone and play things continually over and over while you're sleeping, I have the capability to do that. So if somebody wants to sit this and you lay by your head when you go to bed, you're thinking of this as some type of safety net, so if you have to, you can call. But the problem is, the people that sometimes you may call might have dark hearts themselves and not really care too much about your well-being, and that's a possibility and something that you have to take into consideration.
Find a center in you. I will chew it up and leave. Trust me, trust me, trust me.